Hello, happy No Go Glastonbury. We're not there, you're not there, but we're going to celebrate this afternoon. Have a party. To open up, we've got our favourite opening act, Arlo the Cartwheel Monkey. You may have seen his How to Hula video number 2 today, Arlo has a special guest, his Nana, who is going to be showing you her moves. So send us some comments. We want to know this is working. Here we go. Marilyn, his Nana, has come to her. She's been practicing her hulaing all week from Arlo's tutorials. So.
I think we're going to have to call the fire brigade to get that poi out of the tree.
Yeah, there's poison in the trees. So hello, everybody.
Poison the trees. No.
It is week 14.
Week
14. We are not at Glastonbury. Neither are you, though. So that's all right.
We've made a special effort. We've got some more flashy lights for you tonight. Well, today. I hope you can see the effect. So, it's great. We're not going to drag any old songs out tonight because we're doing the best of. So we've got the 9 best of voted by our fan base of songs of all time. And
only ours, though.
Only ours.
Not that anybody else has written.
We've never done covers, have we? We should do that.
One day. Just before we started, my violin string snapped, so I think it's all right. And it's very, very, very windy.
So it's a bit like a Whitesnake video with Athene's hair at the moment.
Yeah, and the rushing sound of the wind.
So, Richie, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Richie.
That's your sound check. There you go. So we're going to do Year of the Clown. Are we all ready? Are you ready?
Oh, let's do double hula in. Here we go.
Take a breath. String's fixed. Thank you.
atmosphere, it wasn't right. Chaos in the circus, dark feast amongst the fools. Suspicion whispers in each ear, an overwhelming sense of fear. And out of darkness they appear with a crown upon the clown. Who put the crown on the head of the clown? Ringmasters, take a bow. The king banished the acrobats, abolished all the coolest cats. Just a megalomaniac with a circus full of clowns. Who put the crown on the head of the clown? It's the year of the clown. It's the year of the clown. Pull this circus down. It's the year of the clown. It's the year of the clown. Pull this circus down.
Stephen Regan, hi, it's lovely that you're here. There's, who have we got? that's just, I can see Jamie on a Zoom screen down there, that's quite exciting.
Oh, that's a surprise though, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's exciting. Shh. Hello Phil Mellish, hello Emma,
hi, Phil.
Leslie, I can't read your name. Hello, Kate Robinson.
We've got a great big wind muffler on the mic at the moment, so it's sort of obscuring the screen a little bit, isn't it?
I can see it.
You can see it, can you?
Yeah.
Oh, it's
super windy here, and we are having loads and loads of... Because we know that we all go on about Glastonbury, we do go on about it.
Go on about it,
but
don't we?
But what I worked out, I've been going since 1987.
1986 was my first, I think.
My mum took me. I think she regretted it, but changed my life. Completely changed my life. I saw things I didn't know I'd ever see, and that was
it. You know, it was. I think going to Glastonbury made me want to either be a caterer, so you could get in for free, or join a band. I think that's what it was.
Or a climber, so you could climb over the wall.
Well, we did that anyway.
Oh. So I've got so many memories, like 35 years worth of memories of this incredible, beautiful place.
Playing at the Casbah. And the Golden Moon Cafe back in the day, they were, oh. Do you know what? Robbie Williams once came to one of our gigs when I was in a band, psychedelic punk band called Moon Dragon. Yes. Robbie Williams turned up and he was just, he just left Take That and he was hanging out with those unreputables. What were they called? Oasis, that was it. And he turned up and he bought a CD of ours for two bottles of red wine that he was happened to have on his bag. Because he doesn't carry money, Robbie Williams. Anyway, so we gave, yeah, he came and saw our gig and then he made his best album ever and ripped off all my songs. So there you go, Robbie.
And your hairdo.
And my hairdo. And my look. And my voice. So, Robbie, this
what
is for
you.
Now?
What is it?
It's called Drink With God. 1, 2, 3. Actually talkable at this time of day.
And it's probably useful that my parents are here because yes. Therefore we won't There's lots of stories that we will not now say, and that's probably best at this
probably
time
best
of the
that
afternoon.
We don't.
All the children present.
Exactly.
But I did
get the nickname because we once managed to get in backstage of one of the big places, backstages, and we met Pete Doherty and what's her name? She called him the Sparkly Lady.
Kate Moss.
So
he's in the toilets with Kate Moss.
I was nicknamed Deep Pockety because I always had an endless supply of beer in my pockets.
You still are Deep Pockety. We still call you Deep Pockety.
I know. That made me go wrong in that song, actually, thinking about that.
Tessa says, hello everyone from Windy Birmingham. Yeah, I think it's too many anecdotes.
Too many memories. So we're going to do faces. Oh, God, do you want to do it?
I'm going to do a... Oh my goodness, there's so many, I'm trying to read it. Okay. Hi to Scarlett. Thor wishes that he could be dancing with you. Scarlett, Thor wishes that he was there with you. But I think that's Mark, anyway. And Mark Bickley, hello Mark Bickley, I think we spoke to you before, says happy Glastonbury to the T60s crew in Bletchingdon. So I guess you're having a garden party. Hello T60s!
Well, I'm glad you're watching us because there's lots going on, isn't there?
I'm amazed. Thank you so much. Thank you for joining in, everyone.
I'm going to watch David Bowie later. I think you can watch it on catch up. I think it's already been on, I'm not sure. And probably the Levs as well, with their show in 1980, whatever it was.
Yeah.
No, it's 90 something, wasn't it?
No, it's all a blur. 1987
until now.
Blur. It's all a blur. Okay,
Faces.
This one's called Faces.
I hope you're being dazzled by the light show, by the way.
Too many names not to get. Too many faces I have seen.
Everything was well planned, plenty of time in hand, every single day. Dancing in Galicia, dancing to the gaita. Technical and very exciting.
They're still playing.
Why are they still playing?
I don't know. There must be a massive delay. This could be exciting. And so it's. Oh, I'll tell you in a minute. I'll say.
Yeah, they finished now.
Hey!
Hey!
They finished.
Right. So the delay is huge.
The delay is massive. So I'm not quite sure what's going to happen. But we have on our screens today. Birthday boy. Where's?
He probably
can see them.
Hello.
Can you see? Oh, hang on, gotta go that way. There we go.
It's Richie.
It's Richie and it's Jamie.
And Jamie.
Look at that. Hello. And it's Richie's birthday today, so I would like you all to join in with us and sing him a happy birthday. Here we go.
Ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Richie. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Are you having a good day, Richie?
Awesome, mate, thank you.
are you
getting it again? Oh, lovely, thanks.
Are you getting loads of birthday love? Look at that, look at that. Oh, we love you, Richie.
I was worried because I saw your second wine diary, Rich, at midnight.
I tell you what, it's all a bit of a struggle today, that's for sure.
Oh, if you've never seen one of Rich's wine diaries, you might want to check them out. They are comedy gold, especially after midnight. So we're going to carry on with the songs, but it's lovely to see you, dude. Let's do a gig together soon,
anyway,
yeah?
Catch you later, yeah?
And Jamie, love you.
Bye.
Well, that was exciting, wasn't it, boys and girls? That was all a bit of fun. I'm going to open a proper job now, look. Just in a for Richie and all these. Oh, do you want to turn that one down now?
I can hear what everybody's saying. Right. Yay. Okay. So today we're doing our Glastonbury special. We're not doing any of our old new songs. We're doing when you voted for your favourite songs a few months ago, we're doing the top nine that you voted for. So these are the songs that you've chosen today. So it's quite nice, really. It's quite easy. Tim hasn't got to try and remember any words.
I have. I've still got to try and remember the words.
Right,
It's called One Fine Day.
Yeah, it's One Fine Day. If you would like to come and say, if we step back a minute, there is a lovely birthday dedication, but there's no point in me reading it. How will you say it?
Hi everybody, this is especially for David Wheeler, one of my best buddies. It's his birthday today and we were going over to see him, but I had a puncture this morning and I didn't go. But anyway, happy birthday, David.
Happy birthday, David. Happy birthday, David. Thank you. There we go. No point in me saying it. It's also happy birthday to Debbie, who we also like to call Flower, from your daughter Rhiannon. So happy birthday, Debbie. And happy birthday to Colin from Jane and Kerry. That's Colin. Happy birthday. And Richie, you got another happy birthday. That's our Richie. Lots of love from Val and Sean Le Mouton. There you go.
Is that the same Richie? Is that our Richie, is it?
Well, if it isn't, it's another Richie. All right, if it's not, then I don't know. If there's another person called Richie whose birthday it is, and you know Sean and Val, then that's yours. I'm sorry about that. And also, David Pritchard, happy birthday. It's your birthday on Tuesday. Thank you for tuning in. It's much, much, much appreciated. Oh my goodness, another one. Raj, happy 60th, Raj. You are sitting outside your van, having a nice drink in your camping chair. And still rocking out at 60. So thank you, Raj. Thank you for tuning in.
That's
and
cool, man.
Happy birthday, dude. There's another one.
Ages in the mind.
Do them all. There's another one. Happy birthday, Phil. Happy birthday, Phil. And this is from Lizzie and Rita, and they say they're sorry you're not all on your lovely holidays but you're going to be in Florence the ambulance watching the show. So happy birthday, Phil. And there's another one.
Go,
bumper week. Happy
we need
birthday.
Gus Honeybun, don't we?
We do. To Dandy Hughes. Happy birthday, Dandy. And that was yesterday, and you were so loved. And that's from Talia and Ione. Hello, Talia and Ione. So, my goodness, it's a big, big, big old birthday weekend. We're normally celebrating Rich's birthday at a small festival.
I messed up that song as well because I remembered that night out with Joe.
Me and Tim had a 36-hour party once with our mate Joe Lees, who is 6 foot tall. Well, he at the time was 6 foot tall cross-dressing performance artist and...
It was crazy.
But at least 36 hours, wasn't it?
Well, we went to see a band play, and we were dancing at the front, not understanding why nobody was dancing at the front. And it was a really quiet sort of acoustic thing. Who was to know? Hubadilia?
Yes, Hubadilia!
Hubadilia!
It's all so windy, it's putting us all out of tune, isn't it, Athene?
Who have we got? Ruth Sedgwick, thank you very much for your applause. And that's it, I can only read one comment at a time at the moment. So that's the only one that's there. Keep commenting, keep commenting. Oh, I want to say hi to Zaid. I just saw Zaid tuned in. Zaid is from the People's Drink Foundation. If you haven't checked them out, they are brilliant. We miss you, Zaid. We want to do a gig with you really soon. Please.
How did the filming go at Minak? I hope it's good.
Oh, yeah. So, who else have we got? Ork, Tall Tower. That's a brilliant name. Dave Hemblay says, fantastic as usual. And Sue Auckland says, great, thank you. Thank you, guys. We're doing our Glastonbury Best of Set today. Nice and easy. The songs we normally play on stage. And
the songs we normally know quite well.
Normally.
But these aren't normal times, are they, ladies and gentlemen? No, they're not. They're not normal times.
I was just thinking in that during that set, because it's looking like live music is really not going to be a goer for quite a long time to come.
We've been
reading government guidelines. Apparently, we are the most dangerous people you can possibly hang out with ever, because apparently we spit 6 times further than anybody else. So, but I was just thinking, my parents are 4 metres away over there. We're not facing them. There's no...
We could do back-turned gigs.
We could turn our back on everyone and play
and have
acoustically.
The speakers facing that way.
Yeah, and just turn our backs on you and stay a long way apart and just have 2 people at a gig at a time. It might be our only way to earn money at this rate.
Yeah, well, it's going to be a very expensive ticket.
It's at least October before there's going to be any revision on live music anywhere. So... We're in for the long haul.
But you never know, because they change it from day to day, don't they? So you never know.
Cheers, everybody!
Cheers! Cheers and bye! We're running late today.
Shout out to Steve and Mark and all the other volunteer bat carers. I love bats. That's what a lovely job. You're rushed off your feet with little grounded bat babies. And Laura wants to give a big shout out to Steve and Mark. So,
do you know, playing Glastonbury, if you run over time, they take it off your wages.
They do.
Did you know that?
Yeah, there you go. Which for us would be into negative equity already.
Yeah. we did a festival once where they made more on taking the money off our percentage of CD sales from their shop than they actually paid us.
Such is the life of the small time touring act.
Isn't it just?
Right.
Thank you ever so much for all the Days of the Dance videos you sent in. I hope you've seen the video.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
Absolutely gorgeous. And it makes us cry every time we watch it. But we are on the edge at the moment.
Yeah.
It doesn't take much, really.
No.
It doesn't take much, does it, love?
No.
Let's not talk about it, eh?
No.
Let me tell you a curious tale of a dancing play in Strasbourg. The year was 1518. One woman was seized by the strangest compulsion to dance. The solitary figure of Frau Trevier danced through the streets in a forgotten year. Unable to stop, feet rubbed to the bone, she moved to a tune that was all her own as she danced. How she danced. The crowds gathered round this peculiar thing. The spectators swayed and danced in the ring. Unable to stop, feet rubbed to the bone, they moved to a tune that was all their own. And they danced, how they danced, with wild abandon. Ghost.
and they went round and round in the days of your dance. Yes, they went round and round in the days of the dance, of the dance. After days in the dumps, some dead on the ground, hundreds now arrive to their unearthly sound. Unable to eat, they were all skin and bone, yet still they moved to a tune all their own. And they dance with wild abandon, even folks like trance. Yes, they danced, they danced. And they went round and round in the days of the dance. Yes, they went round and round in the days of the dance. Okay, people, let's party!
Natalie Bates, hello.
Hello.
Oh yeah, it's very, very.
Arlo can't stop spinning.
Uh oh, Arlo can't stop spinning today.
You might have to stop.
Who else have I not said hello to?
Arlo, you'll fall over.
I think I've done everybody. Done it all.
So, this next song is Astralize, and it is the most popular song as voted by our fan base that we've ever written ever.
Apparently.
And it's the only one, it's not the only one I play the whistle on. I do quite a few others, but we don't play them very often. And we can't play Stars because it makes us cry. Arlo, you might fall over the next thing happens. And I'd like to dedicate this one
just
to...
Just like Daddy at Glastonbury.
You're right, I did fall over.
You did fall over. He fell over because it's Glastonbury, ladies and gentlemen. It's Sunday afternoon. It's usually the weirdest day of the whole festival because we've had very little sleep because we've been doing gigs till silly o'clock.
And then straight down the kids' field when it opens in the morning.
And then straight down the kids' field with the sandpit.
Basil Brush last year.
Yeah, we saw Basil Brush.
That was brilliant.
Bum bum! But he didn't do bum bum, did he?
Yeah, he did.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, I must have fallen asleep.
Many times.
Did he?
All the time.
What's he doing?
Yeah. Oh. Right, this is Astralize.
It's for Poppy.
It would have been Poppy's birthday today. Much, much love to Buck.
Love you, big guy. Thank you.
my parents.
And they're at Glastonbury Festival. Hey.
Looking over the garden wall, coming to us. Go, dude. Yeah? Hello? He's exhausted.
Well, you can have a little rest. Why don't you go and have a little rest with Nana and Grandad? Do you know what? It's Arlo's first time. He's never been, well, apart from the year they went all, had a year off, didn't they, a couple of years ago. But Arlo's been to every single Glastonbury since he was 6 months old. And he loves it. Kids feels brilliant.
I think I like going as a mum even more than as a party chick.
Well, yeah, if you go into the Green Futures field as well, it's great for the kids there. It's great for the kids in the Greenpeace, the big ship that they are. It's just, it's good for
families.
Let's
hope it happens next year. Do you know what? Though, all the amazing, incredible things that me and Tim don't ever go down to the pyramid stage. So everyone's like, oh, the lineup. What lineup? We don't know.
We did go and see Radiohead the other year. And we went to see Stevie Wonder. Very
but
superstitious.
I was going to say that my favourite thing, actually,
down the wall.
When we all get back, none of us know, when we get back to our vans, and Rich and Ems will be parked next to us, and Jamie and Tegan will be nearby, and Niall, and we all just meet up at whatever time we've all arrived back, and then we sit around the fire, and we laugh and laugh until we cry into the every hour of the night, and I love that. I love that bit. And
we go and find a bar and hang out there.
Oh, it's the Toe and Hitch Backstage Arcadia.
Oh yeah, big up to the Tone Hitch Backstage Arcadia. Well done. Always put on a good party until lunchtime.
Right, we're going to do
World on Its Head.
What time is it?
26 minutes past.
Whoa! We might do one more after World on Its Head. Thank you for tuning in. We love it. We love you being here. We love it that you're there for us. And we're there for you. And we got new t-shirts. Have you seen
new
t-shirts? Do you want to see one? Do you want to see one? It's better that way around.
Camera's better.
I'm going to take it that way.
Take it right up because it's great.
In case you haven't seen them yet, here it is. Oh, that way. And your t-shirt design. We got ladies' vest tops, we got hoodies, we got kids' ones. You can just go to our shop on our Free Laugh Monkeys website.
My apologies to all the people that have either had one missing or one extra in their packages in the last couple of weeks. But
it was a lot to work through.
I'm not really trained in the retail trade before.
As you may have noticed before, our focus is sometimes somewhat shifting. So to pack up 300 t-shirts and focus on it, we got a few more, don't we? But anyway, I love the photos. If you've got your t-shirt, send us a picture of yourself in them because I'm loving seeing them on, because it was so exciting to design them and now.
Especially if you ordered an extra lush and I sent you an extra small.
Or vice versa. Well done, it's head.
Ready?
Yeah. Handstands, headstands, cartwheels, you know the way it works.
1, 2, 3, 4. La 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 la. La 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 la.
One on his head, one on his head.
go, I guess I'll never know. Give a bow to you now and get on with the show.
You've turned the one on his head, one on his head. You turn the one on his head. Spin it round, upside down. You turn the one on his head. One on his head.
We've had in 3.5 months. It's my parents in the back garden, distanced away from us, but still, it's lovely. And we're not singing in their direction. Yes, darling. It's the last song.
It's the last song.
Arlo the Cartwheel Monkey has a new hula hoop tutorial for you.
Oh yes, part two.
Check out his YouTube channel. And
And I'd like to say thank you so much for joining in every week. It's a real, tonic. It's a tonic.
Blown our minds.
It's a tonic.
That you're still here and we're still here and that you're still tuning in every week. And yeah, we will constantly learn different tunes and we'll even try and write a new one soon.
And I know things are lightening up, well, apparently on the 4th of July, but music venues aren't. So please, if you can, write to your MPs and talk to them about, go and see, I can't remember the name of the company.
We'll put the link up.
But there's loads of information on there about how to help the arts and the arts industries that are suffering so much at the moment.
Small venues.
Of this COVID-19 crisis and the fact that no one can really work anymore and all the venues can't work. Even the big venues having trouble. The big PA companies, it's affecting all of us. So if you can sort of see if you can help in any way, that would be great. I'm getting all emotional.
Anyway. Last song.
Antiquated.
Last song. Thank you, Hannah Gibson. You tune in. I love seeing the names coming up every week. I can't wait to put faces to names because I know so many of your names now. Cassie Kerr. We really like her some days. Oh, it's amazing. Thank you, everybody. This is the Antiquated and the Arcane. This is for you. Leap about in your gardens, in your living rooms. And happy birthday, Rich. Do you believe in magic? The fight used to be the power of the earth, with life, love, and antiquity. Of wondrous breathing places, things we can't explain. Curious, mysterious, in a time of the arcane.
Then we are two of a kind. We are magical and twined. I love your soul, you love my mind. We are magical and twined.
2, 3, 4. Hey. very much.
Thank you, everybody. Somebody's someone Beatty has managed to actually watch all of us through different channels and tried to coordinate it all. Arlo has just hooped through the whole show.
Well done, mate.
Amazing. How you doing? How you feeling?
I'm tired and weak.
Tired and weak. That's a Sunday Glastonbury feeling.
Yeah. Are you missing Glastonbury?
Yeah.
What's your favourite thing?
Glastonbury.
The pirate ship. The Greenpeace pirate ship.
Well done, Lozer.
Yeah. And the Arcadia spider, probably.
Yeah, the Arcadia
spider. No, thank you, Phil Mellage.
Oh,
thank you.
What?
It's now a crane.
Oh, it's now a crane, you're right, actually. Yeah, it's not a spider anymore.
Thank Lisa Joan. Thank you so much. Thank you, Maria Gregory. Thank you, Chris Martin. Thank you, and there is a PayPal link if you want to donate any money, and we are so appreciative. We share it with Richie and Jamie as well. Sarah Grattan, lovely to see you. Thank you for tuning in, Chris Selby. Thank you. And what can we say? We love you all, and we just want to be in a field with you partying. Yeah. So we're just in our minds, we are sending you pictures of you partying along with the Three Duck Monkeys. We will be doing this. We will keep doing this. As long as you want us to do it, we'll be doing it, won't we?
We will.
And hope to see you again soon. Marge Mack, thank you. Christy,
well, that's my guitar, but it was a water.
Yeah. Take care.
That's all right.
Be respectful. That's what I think. Keep safe, man.
Oh,
bye-bye. Find the off button now somewhere. Thank you, Dean Mitchell. Thank you, Rosie. Rosie Kilbride, thank you.
Rosie Kilbride?
Yeah.